Hi friends, this is Seema here from Paper Passions, and today we are going to make a gift box. Very easy to do, no cutting required. You just need a scoreboard with a versus scoring tool and a sheet of paper and glue and some decorations that depends on how you want to decorate it. So that's optional and it's completely dependent on your choice. So now that this paper has a grid and you will not be able to see the score lines clearly, I will just go ahead and do the scoring on this side. And you take one 12 by 12 inch paper. Your first score is going to be at the half inch mark. I hope you can see it. I'm doing it at the half inch mark like that. Your second score is going to be at 3 and a quarter, which is about 2 3/4 from this score line. So this is going to be 3 1/4. Next score line is going to be at 2 1/4 inches from this score line. So this will be 4 1/4, 5 1/4, so 5 1/2 inches. So this is where you will put your next score line. You can also choose to do it at 2 1/2. So this is just going to be the width of your box, right? So it can completely go on your own choice, right? One more thing before I go any further is try to choose a paper which does not have an orientation, because when you fold the paper, if it's an oriented paper, then the design may go all upside down. So try to choose a paper which doesn't have any orientation like this one. It's a grid pattern and it doesn't have to be this way or that way. It will look fairly decent both ways. Right, so we are done with the score lines on this side. Now we need to do two more score lines, and then for that we will just turn the paper. Just go turn it over, and on the score that has not been scored here, we will make a line of at 2 3/4. Again, go 180 degrees and 2 3/4, so that we have two scores on this side which are at 2 3/4 from the edge on both sides. Now what we need to do is make sure all the lines are folded and just crease the line so that it will be easier to fold. Now what I'm going to do is create the corners. You fold the paper like this. All you need to do is take this point here, this point here, as you can see, and we will try to touch it to this point here, right there, this corner. So we go ahead and do that like this, and you press it down. As you can see, you just go ahead and press it down like that. So what happens is you create this corner here, and you will repeat it for these two edges, as in this here, and then you can just go ahead and repeat that same thing for this corner like this. And same on the other side. So I'll come back with all the scores done on a different paper. So and we'll take it forward from there. Okay, I'm back here with all the scoring lines done. So we have created these flaps here, and this is the basic structure of our box. All we need to now do is go ahead and glue the pieces, and I'll be back. Now we just need to adhere it like this and like this, and I'll be back. Okay, we are ready with the basic box. So I've gone ahead and glued all the parts, the folded creases together to get this. Now this is the flap. Now we can play around with this flap to give it different looks. If we just gently press it here and fold it over, we could make it into a purse like thing, or we could actually go ahead and score it on the side here and then on the side here, as in this is 2 1/4 inches, so from this portion to 2 1/4 inches, fold it and you could make it into a box. You could also use this flap as a circular flap to make it into a treasure box kind of thing. So one, it all depends on how you want to keep the flap, and you can go ahead and do various things with it. Now, as far as this area is concerned, you can either go ahead and apply some strip of paper like that, coordinating paper, and or you can apply a ribbon and cover this up. You can also leave it blank depending on how you want to go about it. You can also do a coordinating paper on the inside that will give it a more finished and polished look. And then thereafter, once you have the box ready, you can decorate it in various ways. I will show you a few decorations right here. So this is a box that I earlier made, and all I did was I applied ribbon here and took it as the flap to cover it. Took it around a couple of times, and then just glued it down with a few decorations. Now this is suitable for anybody who is a older lady, or somebody young girl, or even any lady would also appreciate this. Now as I said, if you want to make it into a masculine kind of box, which does not require many frills, you can actually, as I said here, you could go ahead and score it, make it a crisp line there, and then taking this as the width, you can make another score line top and at the top, and go ahead and make it into a proper box. So this is a cute little gift box to give to any man, your brother, your father, or any friend would appreciate it. Now if you have this, and this is all the same design, right? So if you have a kid, and so you can also decorate it into a treasure box like I have done here. You can give it a look of a treasure box, and every kid would be excited to open something like this. It's fun. And I hope you go ahead and try these ideas. If you do link me up on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram. I'll leave the links below. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and if you did, please share and subscribe, and leave a like or a comment from you is really appreciated. Thank you. Have a great day ahead. Bye bye.